Jack would like to talk with you when you have a moment.
Hello, Deke. Professor Weasley said you wanted to tell me more about the loom.
Ah, hello. Yes, about that. Deke has had a thought. He... Seems the room thinks you need more space for your beasts. As Deke was saying, he's had a thought. Now, Deke knows how you can test the item of clothing that you enhanced in the enchanted loom and perhaps help an old friend in the process.
What do you mean?
A house elf named Tobbs works for his master, retrieving leech juice in a cave near Hogwarts. Tobbs' master doesn't let him leave the cave, and Deke knows the cave is infested with spiders.
That sounds awful.
It is. Deke hasn't heard from his friend for a while now. As the item you wove in the loom has an enchantment that might be useful, Deke thought you could test it whilst checking on Tobbs.
Well, I suppose if looking for Tobbs also allows me to test my enchanted clothing, then I can do it.
Oh, thank you. Please let Deke know what you learn about Deke's old friend.
Try riding a hippogriff. You'll soon learn that Kagawa's techniques are lacking practical.
This Sedalian Keys challenge is coming along nicely.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
be Tob's cave. I suppose I should head inside.
Nothing. Would have preferred. Oh.
What's this?
Let me enter.
Is this your best trick? All right, you've had your fun.
This looks like just the loveliest of places.
Tob's master is awful.
Revelio. Tob's? Deke sent me. Are you in here?
It looks as if Tob's was here some time ago. Must have headed deeper into the cave.
Confringo! Revelio. That didn't sound particularly reassuring. Revelio.
Thank you.
There's a victory that came none too soon. Revelio! Revelio. Confringo! Oh no. I have a feeling that House Elf is Tobbs. Poor Tobbs. Left here alone with the spiders. Confringo! Revelio! Revelio. The table looks familiar. Seems I'm back at the entrance to the cave. Revelio!
I'm back from the cave, Deke.
Wonderful. Deke hopes you gave Deke's best to Tobbs.
I'm sorry to tell you this, Deke, but Tobbs is gone. It seems he was unable to avoid the spiders in the end.
Oh my! Deke was afraid of this, alone in that cave for so long. Oh, poor Tobbs. Deke and Tobbs once shared the same master. When he died, we were separated. Deke always wished Tobbs had been sent to Hogwarts too. Deke feels lucky to serve such kind witches and wizards like you. Deke will miss his friend dearly, and will raise a glass to him with a heavy heart.
I'm truly sorry about your friend, Deke.
Thank you. You are very kind. Deke could use some time alone to think, if that's all right.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Could this be Mr. Oakes' campsite? And Rogue's loyalists, just ahead. Should I take them by force or be discreet?
I'll snap that one and your neck.
Stop it!
Easily diverted. Was that your best?
Someone's been taken out last me!
Coming back this way.
Now, to find out what happened here.
I'm just thinking we can probably piece together what happened by the fact this dude's gone and there's a bunch of goblins.
Mr. Oakes's trade journal. Adelaide said that her uncle kept notes of his trades, maps. Perhaps these landmarks will lead me to him. Mr. Oakes's trade journal.
Revelio.
I should investigate.
Revelio. Revelio.
Are I don't trust Ranrok, I'll tell you that. He'll turn on us first chance he gets.
Oh, you're wasting your time with her, my friend. I've seen her show more affection to a hawk lump.
But then it was ours. If it isn't the herbology master, always bringing fire.
You made a grave mistake. You're going to regret that.
Quite the impressive fight.
Come on, are you afraid to fight back?
You let Nora Treadwell go.
Wait till Sebastian hears about this. An Ashwinder.
Ah, but you trusted the wrong kind, and we see you about to echo your folly. You're a slippery little... What have you done? If it isn't the little combat god...
Revelio. What do we have here? Have more luck higher up in the keep.
The student from the town!
You haven't had mushrooms.
This is the spot of the map. I'd best have my wits on me.
You're making this too easy.
Stone walls do a prison make, sometimes. Revelio. I don't like the looks of that encampment.
Meant for me?
What will we find in here?
Revelio! Confringo! Revelio! Confringo! Leviosa!
You should know better than that by now. We've all told you before, and look what happens when...
I could have sworn I heard something. What was that? I feel as though I'm not alone. It's punishment to us all to have that miserable human around.
No!
I shall avenge your death. You won't get away with that.
Instincts were spot on.
Your blood's on Ranrock's hands. Revelio. Alohomora.
I fall dead asleep on my finger.
A human's word is worthless. This prisoner owes us the metal we were promised. Renrod's vision of goblins ruling over the city.
Who do you think you are?
That student defeated our encampment in the town.
I'm a...
A boiler door. How to open it?
You won't be able to stop Ranrock. I'll kill you when I get down.
Revelio. What's down there? Revelio. Hello? Mr. Oakes?
Yes, I'm here. They've taken my wand. This cell has an enchanted lock. I have experience with these locks, but I need my wand if I have any chance of opening it. Look for a boiler door. I've heard them speak of it.
I need to find Mr. Oakes's wand. Where could it be?
Revelio.
Thank you. This door must need power from something. You to learn the error of your ways. Revelio. This must be Mr. Rooks's wand. Perhaps now he can set himself free.
My wand. I can't get out of this damn cell without it. It's my last hope. Please.
My wand. Oh, thank you. You did it. I found my wand and... Wait. You're a student? Oh, we must get you to safety immediately. It's dangerous.
It's all right, Mr. Oaks. I've dealt with these goblins before.
Dear Merlin, you're either very lucky or very talented. How did you find me?
I'm a friend of Adelaide's. She was worried about your business with Ranrock's loyalists.
Oh, she was right to be. I couldn't go through with the agreement, and when I told them, I ended up blindfolded and behind bars. Been locked in that infernal cell for so long, they'd forgot I was even there. I overheard things. If only I could reward you for what you've done. Blasted goblins stole every canut on me. All I can say is thank you, truly.
Am I right that you speak gobbledygook?
Unbeknownst to Ranrock's fiends, I do. I've always had an affinity for goblin culture. Knew I wanted to be a metal trader ever since I was a lad. It wasn't easy learning the language. It's complex, and my memory's as weak as my knees these days. But after decades working with fine goblin folk, I grew fairly proficient. At least, I'd like to think so.
You mentioned you overheard things.
Sad tale, really. I think I know where Ramrock's unfortunate vendetta against wizardkind began. Although dragon breeding was outlawed by the Warlocks' Convention of 1709, Ranrock stumbled upon an illegal dragon camp. He was young, found the creatures fascinating. He'd visit the camp in secret whenever he could, never making his presence known. After weeks of sly surveillance, he finally summoned the courage to speak to the wizard in charge. Ranrock wanted to join them and the creatures. The wizard happened to drop his wand. Ranrock saw an opportunity. He picked it up, went to hand it back as a means of introducing himself. The sight of a goblin with a wand sent the wizard into an instant rage. He beat Ranrock nearly to death. Ever since, Ranrock has despised wizardkind, sees us all as cruel.
I'm grateful I was able to help you, Mr. Oakes. Adelaide thinks the world of you.
Oh, and I her. She's become quite savvy to my trading habits, always analyzing my detailed owls. Oh, if only I hadn't resorted to trading with such fiends. A lesson I shan't soon forget. Having my wand back is like being reunited with an old friend. I must return home and inform Adelaide of my safety. Will you be all right?
I'll be fine, Mr. Oakes. You get back to Adelaide. I assure you, her worries outweigh yours.
Oh, I'm anxious to see my dear niece. And then I plan to travel far from here for my next round of trading. Thank you. May life reward you justly for your deeds. Be well, my friend.
Mr. Oakes was lucky. Ranrock's lot would never have freed him. Rebellion. never get any more cozy than Hogsmeade.
Welcome. Do let me know if I can be of any assistance. What can I do for you today? Here you found a bit of treasure in the forest. It was never one for advent. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Revelio. Hogsmeade, here I come.
Beetle the guard of the mystery and hairy hearted for my taste.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Revelio.
try.
I've been turned around on the grand staircase one too many times. I simply avoid it now.
And your reading is the dragon. That's exciting, I suppose. Perhaps you're due for an adventure.
Ladies?
Professor Shah.
Astronomy is not divination. You won't find the mysteries of the cosmos charted out on your palms or at the bottom of your teacups. Alas, the heavens remain hazy to the starry-eyed. Now, if you were to devote yourselves to persistent and painstaking observation, you just might catch a glimpse. With that in mind, please take your telescopes. Tonight we will be on the observation deck. Still don't have your own? You can't be the new student forever, you know. You can share with Mr. Takar.
Here, I can adjust that for
you. No, bring it into focus on your own. Now, I expect all of you to put in your stargazing hours outside of class. Is that clear?
But, Professor, it's freezing out.
Mere cold didn't stop the great stargazers of the past. Look only to the astronomy tables they erected throughout the highlands from which they gazed millennia ago on the very selfsame stars above us. Is that clear? Dismissed.
Hello again. Brilliant class, wasn't it? I prefer astronomy over potions, don't you? Of course, we Ravenclaws tend to do well in any class.
Oh, hello, Emmett. Nice to see you again.
Did I hear Professor Shaw say that you don't have your own telescope?
I have a spare one you could borrow for the rest of term.
I can't do that, Ahmed. You might need it.
No, really. You can. And I won't. It's my old one. I finally got my hands on the new Celestia Contemplor. You've heard of it, I assume? I mean, of course you have. It's only the pinnacle of all personal stargazing implements. But my old model's not too shabby either. Goblin-cut glass, first-rate optical enchantments. Hate to think such a fine instrument is just collecting dust.
Well, I... Thank you, Ahmed.
Think nothing of it. Anyway, the telescope's in the storage room right underneath us. You can't miss it. I have some, reading to finish on the lower deck. Come find me there afterwards and bring the telescope. There's something I want to talk to you about.
I tried to put off my stargazing as long as I could.
Revelio! This was his old telescope. Looks practically brand new.
A pristine night for stargazing.
Professor Shah's just about as cold and distant as the bloody stars she wants us to chart. Not how I wanted to spend my evening.
Not sure what you can learn from these astronomy tables that you can't learn from a cup of tea leaves.
Almeet thinks he knows everything. Even told me he can speak gobbledygook. Sounded like gibberish to me.
I had heard about these odd stone tables out in the Highland. Perhaps that's what Professor Shah was talking about.
The constellations are beautiful. Not sure they're worth dying of a cold for, but they are beautiful.
Professor Shah, I'm interested in learning more about astronomy.
It is increasingly rare to find a student who seeks after things celestial, of their own accord. But if you truly desire to chart the courses of the cosmos, you must rid your mind of the terrestrial babble of others. We ourselves are not unlike blank star charts, you know? Empty canvases waiting to be inscribed with all that the universe has to offer. Do you understand?
Am I right in thinking you are unimpressed by divination?
Of the many other so-called disciplines taught here, divination is perhaps the most feeble, especially in its nonsensical practice of astrology. Do not confuse astronomy and astrology. One is concerned with mysteries, stellar and lunar. The other is mere lunacy.
You mentioned astronomy tables earlier in class. What were you talking about?
Long ago, devotees of the astral arts set up stone slabs across the countryside. They are ideal for studying constellations near and far. For centuries, wizards made use of these astronomy tables for stargazing. Sadly, they have since become mere monuments to the intrepid intellectual pursuits of a bygone epoch.
Thank you, Professor. I look forward to stargazing.
I am glad to hear it. Should be a stellar night for it.
The perfect night for... Oh, hello again.
I have the telescope. It's nicer than I had expected.
I would not offer a prospective stargazer a third-rate lunoscope. But there is, something else.
Yes? What is it?
You remember those astronomy tables Shah was going on about? It just so happens I've been reading up on them a little myself. And it seems there may be one right here at Hogwarts. I believe we could use it to find hidden constellations.
Ah, I had a feeling there would be a catch to that telescope.
No. I certainly wasn't trying to bribe you or anything. But are you in? No one from the Gobstones Club will go with me. Said they'd rather get spit at by a stone than... Well, they are cowards. Let us get moving while the stars are still out. I'll show you how to use that telescope once we get there. I promise.
Oh, no need to convince me. Let's get going.
Brilliant. You won't regret it. Shall we? The table is on a castle wall ahead. Look for a stone platform, something that doesn't quite belong. We'll know it when we see it. Onwards we go. Some say the locations of the tables were originally marked by centaurs for ritual stargazing. Huh. It is nice having a fellow stargazer to explore with.
Happy to be here. It is good to leave the classroom now and then.
It's not that creepy out here at night, is it? The Gobstones Club are cowards. Here I am, charging ahead. Why don't you lead the way?
If you're sure.
Revelio.
A little foreboding.
A few cobwebs and some dust. Nothing to be concerned about.
Oh, of course. It's just not as tidy. More cobwebs. You don't think any spiders might be lurking about?
Oh, no. Not this close to the school, Emmett.
Look! There's a table! I think you should do the honors. Go on, try it out. The constellation should appear near the center of your view. As soon as you've lined up the telescope, we will be able to fill out our star chart. I was right about the tables. They really are gateways to the far stars, just as the book said. And your contribution was invaluable. Rest assured, you shall be credited in my memoirs one day.
Whatever you say, Emmett. Whatever you say.
Oh, you wait. You are going to be quoted saying just that. This is only the beginning. You will find more tables like this one throughout the grounds and forest, all beckoning to be discovered by a worthy astronomer. And if I have ever seen one, it's you. Oh, and about my old telescope. Don't bother returning it. You should keep it.
That's quite generous. Thank you.
You are welcome. It has goblin-cut glass and a gobbledygook inscription. I'm practically fluent in gobbledygook, you know. It's all in the throat, really, gobbledygook, you know, and how you pronounce your R's. Anyway, glad our adventure was a success. I will see you soon. Never do get tired of seeing the astronomy tower at night. What a view.
I have learned of a wizard who is being harassed by Harlow. He may be able to provide the evidence we need to take Harlow down. We should speak with him together. Meet me at his home.
I assume you have news regarding the goblin you mentioned. Why don't we meet at the map chamber to discuss that and our next steps?
I wonder who lives here.
Handy resource indeed,
Revelio.
Your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Revelio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place. Mind now, demiguys.
I pressed ominous regarding Salazar Slytherin's scriptorium. My end. Meet me outside the Slytherin common room. We need to talk.
Revelio.
What's doing?
Is everything all right?
If the Hamlet sent you here to talk to me about... I know what I have to do. It's not every day a girl has to put down her own troll. I should be allowed to work up to it.
What do you mean, your own troll?
I thought that's why you were here. I'm sorry. I suppose if you spend enough time with trolls, you forget your manners. I'm Alexandra. I didn't mean to be short with you. With Ranrock's lot seemingly everywhere, I thought the Hamlet could use a bit more security. But my plan has gone awry. I apologised when he almost trampled half the Hamlet yesterday. He just needs more time. But everyone wants him gone. They think it's mad, my training a troll. Impossible, even.
I'm inclined to agree with them. Trolls are dangerous creatures.
I know, but I had to try. I suppose I understand why everyone's been so concerned. What made me think I could train him? I should have learned from Barnabas the Barmy. But he's my troll and my problem. I'll be honest, I'm afraid I won't be able to take care of him. He's stronger than any troll I've ever encountered. I wish I knew someone else who could do it.
What exactly were you training the troll to do?
I was hoping to train him to serve as protection for us. Frankly, I struggled to teach him even a word or two. Couldn't give him even a semblance of self-control.
Who's Barnabas the Barmy?
Surely you've seen the tapestry of him at Hogwarts. It hangs in the 7th floor corridor. He allegedly tried to train trolls for the ballet. You can imagine how that turned out.
I'm not thrilled at the prospect, but I'll consider it.
Oh, no. I didn't mean to suggest that you should do it. In fact, you should avoid the area just southwest of here. At least until I work up the courage to do what needs to be done.
A troll on the loose near a hamlet. That could be devastating. I take it you're Alexandra's friend?
Yeah.
fault for Alexandra, but the hamlet needed to be saved from that troll. Revelio. Like a place right out of a storybook. It's done, Alexandra. I took care of him.
My troll? What? Oh, I don't know what to say. Thank you. I wish things could have turned out differently for him.
Any plan you had to train that thing was doomed. He tried to kill me the entire time.
Goodness. I'm glad you're all right. You're very brave. People in the hamlet had already crafted a moniker for whoever eventually defeated my... I mean, that troll. It was Troll something or other.
Vanquisher?
Yes, that was it. I suppose it's your title now. I need some time on my own. But truly, thank you for what you did.
The Troll Vanquisher. Suppose I did earn the title.
Welcome, welcome. Do have a look around.
Hello again, Mr. Thistlewood.
Oh, it's you again, my favorite Hogwarts student. Never attended Hogwarts myself. In fact, I've never been more than a stone's throw from our humble hamlet. Now, how may I be of service?
You never wanted to get out and explore the world around you.
Hard to believe, isn't it? Especially for someone so young. But no, some folk just aren't born with the need to wander. My sister Helen, on the other hand, she saw some of the world in her time as an aura. But I'm happy here.
What do you have for sale?
Now, how can I help? Thank you. I hope to see you again soon.
Revelio. Wonder who lives here.
I wish I'd paid more attention when I was at Hogwarts.
Chores aren't so bad. I don't mind the odd one without magic.
A full day's work clears the mind, I say.
Revelio.
Working as a referee for professional sports.
Revelio.
You scoundrel! I do not pay for all your school things to be rewarded with a house full of hexes! Your father's in St. Mungo's to get his horns removed, and it's taken the house elf a week to unstick that screaming portrait! A week! You will behave, or so help me Merlin, I will bring you straight back home!
Last week, I performed a knee reversal on a second.